Hopefully you saw my video last week about the new GivEnergy EV charger. If not, I'll stick a link to that down in the description for you. Well, my preferred way to keep an eye on all of my smart devices is by using Home Assistant. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to get the EV charger connected to Home Assistant using GivEnergy's cloud API. At the time of putting together this video, local control of the GivEnergy EV charger using the GivTCP add-on is still under development, so I put together a workaround that uses the GivEnergy Cloud API to monitor and control it instead from Home Assistant. So rather than Home Assistant talking directly to the charger over your local network, this method requires an internet connection because Home Assistant will talk to GivEnergy servers and those servers will communicate with your charger. Let's take a look at how to set this up. Right, before we even get started on Home Assistant, we need to get an API key from GivEnergy. So we visit givenergy.cloud, and I'm already signed in here, but normally you'd get a login page here. We go down to account settings and manage account security at the top right. We scroll down a little bit, we want manage API tokens. Now I've already got two tokens here. One is my one that I'm actually using, and another one is a local API token. For this demonstration, I'm going to generate a brand new token that is only going to be temporary, so please don't try and use it, it won't work. I will delete it afterwards. So here we go, generate new token, and I'm going to call this HA test, and I'm going to expire this in 7 days. You'll probably want to choose no expiry or whatever you think is appropriate, but just bear in mind if you do set an expiry time, then you'll have to come in and create a new one and reconfigure Home Assistant afterwards. You can just tick give it everything, or you can go in and give it specific permission just for the EV charger here if you want. I'm going to give it everything for now just to keep this demo simple, and then you go create token. Okay, now you need to click this copy to clipboard because you'll only get this token once, and if you don't copy it and paste it somewhere safe, you could lose it forever and you'd have to do that again. So I've basically pasted it here into Kate, which is a text editor, just as a temporary measure. Back over in Home Assistant, and we're going to need to edit our configuration files. The easiest way to do that is to install the file editor add-on, and we do that by going to settings, add-ons, add-on store. I'm going to search for file editor, there it is, click on it, click on install. I'll speed this up a little bit, I'll be back once it's done. Okay, we're back, and once it's installed, we do need to start it. So I'll click on this little start button here, and show in sidebar makes it a lot easier to use, because once it has started, we can then click on this file editor icon in the menu on the left hand side. Okay, once it's started, click on file editor. Now we need to find a file called secrets.yaml. You can see I'm already actually in this because I was in it before, but you click on that little icon in the top left, scroll down until you find secrets.yaml, and you click on it and you'll get taken here. Now I've got some configuration I've worked on already, and I'll put all of this up on my website for you so as you can copy and paste it nice and easily. But essentially all we're going to do is paste in a new line here for an item called givenergy_API key. And you'll see the value here is bearer, and then I've put in your API key. So we need to go and get the actual API key that we generated from the GivEnergy portal. I'm going to copy that to the clipboard, and I'm going to paste it over the top. So you can see there is a little quote at the end, a little double quote at the end. So this whole thing is in quotes, and it says bearer and then your API key. And we're just going to save that now. Now we need to go and edit our actual configuration file. So we go to browse file system and down to configuration.yaml. Now, if you've already got lots of stuff in here, then you might need to do a bit of rearranging. But if you've got a clean installation, which is pretty much what I've got here, then you can just go to my website and grab all of the configuration items. I'm just copying that to my clipboard here and paste them straight in. You'll need to save that, and then you can restart Home Assistant to apply it. I'm just going to Developer Tools. I'm going to check the configuration to make sure it's all valid. Restart and restart Home Assistant and give that a few minutes to come back up. Once that's restarted, we'll probably need to make use of those new controls and things that we've just created. I'm going to edit my dashboard. You can see here I've got a little EV charge dashboard here. And if I go to edit dashboard, I'm going to add a card of type entities. If I go to show code editor, now back in my little code file here, I can copy this entities card that I've pre-made. That will be on the website too, don't worry, and paste that into there. If I click on save and done, you'll see we've got this nice little dashboard showing all of the controls and sensors that we've just created. That entities card basically shows you all of the sensors and controls that we've just created. You might not want to display all of those. For example, you might not want to show the mode sensor because the states of the various mode switches already tell you this information. One thing you need to be aware of is that the sensors only update every 15 seconds in order to keep API calls to a minimum. So when you toggle a switch, it could take up to 15 seconds to register. The switch might look like it turned off on its own for a few seconds, but it'll jump back again once the API confirms it has worked. Anyway, I hope that you found this useful. Don't forget that if you want local control, then you'll want to look at GivTCP instead, which, if it's not fully supporting the charger already by the time you watch this, then it will be very soon, so check the video description for an update. Please give this video a like and subscribe to my channel to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.